And domestic abuse saw a steep increase during the height of the pandemic. News 12's Eileen LaPalmer takes a look at the numbers and what's being done to help keep them down.
But as time went on, it got worse and worse.
Josephine Hodge survived more than a decade of physical and emotional abuse at the hands of a boyfriend, even needing reconstructive surgery on her nose. Today, she speaks about it, hoping to encourage others to get help.
It's swept under the rug a lot. A lot of people will not come out and say that things are going on. There's nothing wrong with getting help. The shame is not getting help and ending up dead.
In the early days of the pandemic, police departments across our area reported a spike in calls for domestic violence. In Suffolk County, the number of domestic violence victims increased by about 200 from 2019 to 2020. In Nassau, that number jumped by 130.
Victims of abuse were home with their abuser, and this is the first time in our history where they were isolated. Isolation is one of the biggest tools an abuser has.
As for today, the end of 2021, Keith Scott with the Safe Center Long Island says there's been a drop-off in people reporting abuse, but he says it's still happening.
It's really hard to call for help when the abuser's right next to them.
And here in Suffolk County, the Suffolk County Police Department has a domestic violence bureau with officers dedicated to continued outreach for victims.
Working as a liaison and advocate for them to help them through the process and the aftermath of filing their police report.
Sergeant Kelly Hartell is the commanding officer of the Suffolk Police Department's Domestic Violence and Elder Abuse Bureau.
It can be going on for a long time subtly that you don't realize. And when you start to hear other examples of people who have gone through something similar to you, you realize maybe that's not the way to go. Maybe I need to make a change.
But I stayed because I didn't love myself. I didn't love me. You never realize that they're a monster because people wear masks.
I'm Eileen LaPalmer for News 12.
And October is Domestic Violence Awareness Month. So for a list of resources, you can go to our website, news12.com.